Put that hashtag REC win, or if you want Mineski to win, hashtag MSKI win. So let's see. The ninth round commence. Of course, we're not going to put too much commitment to this one because it's the ninth round.
It's the ninth round. And yes, the stabby McStab stab is about to happen. Bunch of beautiful knives coming in from both teams. Let's start off with the line Rekka Esports. They are now killing, stabbing McStab stab. Stabby. And Rekka wins the stabby McStab stab round.
So now let's see, as it looks like they're going to stay on the CT side, definitely a good choice right there.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever you win the knife round, I think they most would likely just go on the CT, you know, get the, I think the much more comfortable side.
Yeah, CT side on Cobblestone, that's the more laid back, because T side Cobblestone, that's going to, you know, you have a lot of choices to make. It's either you go to B through drop, through long, or go through A, through mid, or through long. In which you can just, if you're playing CD, you can just have two people guarding each.
Right now, Dubstep may actually be spotted out here, as there's going to be the backstab coming in from Supersys, and they get taken down right off the bat. Now you can see that Mineski are going to try to at least control onto the B side, coming in from the drop zone, but damn, look at that shot coming in from Frost Mist, the only retract going to remain in a 3v1 situation. Already spotted out, but the aim from Rekka Esports just too damn strong, wiping out Mineski. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy.
And yeah, Rekka will be taking the pistol around here, and they are going to buy up the SMGs. Mineski gonna try to see if they can find the answer to this by forcing the CZs, Tech-9s, and a couple of utilities actually, which is pretty nice. So three Tech 9s, a CZ, and a P250 for Mineski, and this is going to be a B push here.
Are they gonna go for like the?
Yeah, they're going
for the rush. It doesn't look like it though. It
doesn't look like a rush because I don't know. They're just waiting for an opening. This is a typical Mineski thing. If they are losing, I mean, if they lost a round, they tend to keep it cool. They're gonna go ahead and talk about it. You know, talk about it and buy time, what they're gonna do, which is pretty standard for every team. But what they do is they just wait for openings. They wait for at least one guy to fall down or two guys to fall down.
Well, I think the shining light here for Mineski is that they could get punished, as Rekka all bought UMPs, thinking that Mineski may actually go for a full save, but Mineski buying up right here. You know, it's not an anti-eco round, this is a force buy round. But yeah, Benset spotting it out already, getting tagged to 50, but he's gotten so much information right now. Mineski coming out from the woodwork, and he does get flashed perfectly there, but not yet shut down. And he still survives. How does he do that one? And now they're going to be trying to overrun Supersys here. Spots out a couple of them, but dies immediately to Mineski. Two kills already. Benset and Frost Misty going to be the ones to remain. Will they actually go for the cut or for the clutch here, and or will they just save their weapons?
And yeah, the Tech-9 buys are starting to pay off for Mineski, being able to take down the three guys. That's going to punish the economy for Rekka Esports. And right now, the momentum is now on Mineski. Time is ticking. Rekka Esports, they are going to offer saves here, which is a smart decision. They already lost three UMPs and a couple of utilities there. They need to save as much money as they can get, and Mineski is scavenging from the dead bodies of Rekka.
At the same time, if you actually look at it, Frost Misty and Bentet, or B and Tet, actually have defuse kits. So coming in onto the next round, if they're able to actually... Oh,
all right.
I don't know how to disable that.
Oh my god.
You do it, man.
All right, I'm just going to disable the audio settings because, you know.
It's off, dude.
Oh yeah, everything's off.
See?
Oh, it's music.
No, that actually has to be. But back again to what I was saying, they bought the defuse kits, and I mean, coming into this round, if they're able to actually get a numbers advantage and, you know, go for the retake, those two defuse kits can actually, you know, make or break this round for them if they want to get back the momentum quickly, as we have just only started the game.
Yeah, and the momentum, the momentum's not shifting to one particular side just yet. I mean, we are seeing Mineski just hanging back there. They are chilling at tunnels. Just waiting for an opening there, and the opening is actually happening right now. Adrian boosts Dispenser up there at long, trying to go for the off angle. And they're not committing just yet, actually.
But you can see here that Rekka Esports are going to be force buying into, again, UMPs. But Mineski only have 3 AKs. So, again, if you're going to be using the SMGs at close range, it could still work. And they're playing these really clustering angles. Look at Rousseau, as well as Bentet, playing around these corners right now. But Mineski going to be pouring in from B-Long. Dispenser gets a good kill onto Rousseau. Spots up Bentet, but Bentet winning that duel right there. And it's going to be Frost Misty at the fountain. Gets taken down as well.
And the B-take is now happening here for Mineski. It's a 3v1 situation. X-Curate is on his own. With a UMP and a flashbang, he may be still able to retake this. And he actually takes down Gee. It's now down to a 1v2 situation. He still has time to work here. He has the... Oh, wait. He doesn't have the DB skits. My bad. But yeah, right, he spots Retract at long. I'm going to try to see if he can pick it up, but Retract takes him out. It's now 1-2 in favor of Mineski.
Yeah, a little bit of, unlucky time there for X-Curate, just because he was looking at... It looked like he was looking for an AK at the ground, but... Everything he saw was just UMPs.
Yeah, everybody had UMPs, and their force buys are actually going to bite them now. They are only able to buy... Rekka are only able to buy 3 CZs, a USP, and a 5-7. Mineski, on the other hand, is fully bought, except for Adrian, sticking with that UMP, which is a good call.
Dispenser spotting out Frost Misty as he was going to be pushing up onto the B-long stairs, but now flushed out by that... a Molotov, but Spencer still has the angle. Frost Misty is trying to bait it out,
nice,
but
shot.
Spencer has, of course, an AK-47, so he'll win that duel right there. But now, you can see that Rekka Esports did buy 3 CZ-75s now in their inventory. So
3 CZs. If they stack near the entrances to the side, that CZ might pull off. I mean, I don't rely on the CZ for long distance encounters. So you just make use of the spray. And Dispenser sees ahead of Rizzo there and then takes him down, and the full-on B-Rush is going to go in here for Mineski. X-Curate, the only person in sight right now, going to try to see if he can stop the plan, but G takes him down, and it's now down to a 5v2 situation.
Now it's CZ-75s. I can only see that it's going to be Rekka Esports looking for the exit frags. Rekka, or rather Bentet's going to be boosted up here, but spotted out by Retract, but Bentet, look at that control, as well as that foresight to actually know where Retract was going to be at, and Super Assist as well, spots out Dispenser, so this is actually looking a little bit bad for Mineski. I mean, yeah, they got the bomb plant down, but
ooh,
at the same time...
that thought, though. Bentet going to try to get a double kill, but it's not going to happen. Adrian takes him down, so they denied Bentet of that AK. And Dubstep cleans everything up.
That could have been a more terrible play coming out of Mineski, just because of how much skill comes out from Bentet as well as Super Assist.
Exactly.
Although, of course, the aim punch battle did kind of, force them to lose those weapons, but still.
But still.
16-1 confirmed. This chat is going a little bit wild.
There is no drop here. This is not a different tournament that has drops.
Rousseau was really fast on that one too.
Now, right now everybody's coming back, and we are seeing Adrian with an AWP. Just a little background: Mineski's primary offer back then was Getsimov. Getsimov left Mineski and moved to Imperium Pro Team. Five Peaks and Imperium Pro Team, so Dubstep had to take the mantle. But Dubstep originally was a rifler for Mineski, and during the time that Getsimov left, he started picking up the AWP more. And a good thing that they picked up Adrian, because Adrian is actually one of the best operators here in the Philippines, and he's going to be a valuable asset to Mineski at this point.
That was kind of a 50-50 play coming in from Mineski. You have to give it to them to actually being to control their hand and not just forcing themselves onto Elon, because you saw there that X-Curate had a good angle. It was smoked out, but at the same time, nobody actually pushed in, and Mineski kind of wasted time on that one. And you saw that,
Adrian.
You just saw there that Mineski actually kind of lost control and lost two of their teammates without actually doing anything. And now Excurate has an AWP onto the A site. He's gonna go a little bit back into the area, spots out Dubstep, looking for Adrian, the other Opera, and he wins that duel as well. And it's going to be Frost Misty from downtown, from the balcony, to actually kill GII, and that's going to be a round back for Rekka Esports.
It's now 2-3, still in favor of Mineski, but this is still anybody's ball game. We're reading the chat. A lot of people are saying that it's going to be easy for Rekka, and that this is one of Rekka's best map as well, so I don't know, this is just
best map for best map.
Best map versus best map.
That's an interesting matchup already for me.
I mean, I could say Mirage is Mineski's actual best map. Cobblestone is just next to it. That's what I'm thinking.
But you also have to like how Rekka Esports approaches their CT defense. They always try to keep mixing it up, not allowing Mineski to actually read how they play it out. And that's kind of good in a way that Mineski has to check all of their corners every single time, because it's going to be like, oh, this round he's there. Sometimes he's, next round he's not there, and then next round he's not there, but then, you know, these kind of mind games is actually what's allowing Rekka Esports to kind of slow down the pace of how Mineski do it, and it kind of shows off that Mineski on that previous round lost a lot of momentum, and now you can see the Spencer going to find the one kill,
and
but Frost Misty is still
drop.
Here.
The drop is now coming in. It's actually going to go rotate to A, and Supersys is right there. Going to try to see if they can stop the momentum, and Gee actually take down Supersys. And the train that is Mineski is still going in for A. Excurate is the only guy guarding A side. He misses
the
shot, but Adrian takes him down. It's now down to a 2v2 situation. It's not looking good for Mineski at this point. They are pretty low.
But there's 40 seconds left onto the clock, and they do know that they tag a couple of the members of Rekka. Adrian trying to play away from that flash, but GII saving him with the M4A1S, or M4A4 rather. Now Frost Misty's gonna dunk that nade!
Oh, that's not gonna be enough!
GII.
Almost kills him.
A little bit scary there.
Not 2v1 situation, Gee.
But gets the headshot. Look at that.
Gee cleans everything up. Now it's now 2.
How are we gonna pronounce that? GII or
Gee? It's Gee. Because it's Young Gee.
Alright, fine, Gee. You're actually right.
I'm always right.
Go, Rekka, you can do this because you are
because
nice.
You're naive.
Nice.
I'm always right. I'm always right, man. Come on.
Okay. So 2-4 scoreline. A little bit
it's not set in stone yet. I mean,
yeah. I mean, this is still pretty early.
Yeah, and Rekka force buying the 2 seasons and a single armor. Ooh, Spencer actually gets taken down by Super Sister at middle. And retract, getting a double kill, taking out Excurate and Supersys. It's now down to a 4v3 situation. They still have... Mineski's already in the site.
But at the
Rosso
same time, they don't know
that...
Yeah, Rosso is at lower mid here, so you could actually get a sneaky biggie kill like that. USP, of course, has a silencer, so they don't really know where...
Kill! It's just retract on his own, and he's pretty low against two pistols? That's...
They did not expect Rosso to actually... To actually have
a backup, yeah.
Yeah, from Benten. And that kind of messed it up for Mineski there. And long-range CZ.
Mid-range. I mean, wow, that was actually a beautiful play. As long as you have a backup, always go for the refrags. Always go for the frags.
Yep. But it doesn't look like Benten was actually right behind Russell there. He just came right after he died. So he rotated quickly from where he was before. But still, the mindset from Rekka Esports is incredible in this match.
Guys, there is no giveaway. You don't need to tag those in chat. But hold that thought. Gee takes down Bentet. And it's a 5v4 situation. Still pretty doable. Mineski is hanging back here at Tunnel Sand. It's actually looking... It looks like they forced the rotate here from
This could be the silver lining for Mineski, because even if they lost the previous round, they still have money to buy. They killed Bentet, which is a thorn on their side for these past couple of rounds. He has been that guy who has made all these phenomenal comebacks. Even on a eco round, they win against Mineski by just pure positioning and communication.
Exactly, and this is completely different from 1.6, because in CSGO, if you're on the eco round, there is still a chance for you to win. In 1.6, if
Frost
you're
Misty
on the eco
could get round, a mow down right here. He spots out the Spencer, flashed away, but it takes down Adrian as well, and he will get taken down right now. But that was a 2-for-1 in terms of the trade. Dubstep and Retract remain Make that only dubstep.
It's just dubstep on his own. He's going to run away with that AK-47. He's not going to be able to. Oh, wait, hold on.
He does have the bomb.
He has the bomb. He has time to get the plant. And I think Rekka's going to be able to read that. And oh, no, they haven't read it yet. Dubstep is going to get a free plant here.
They're still looking.
Dubstep is going to get a free plant. And Dubstep doesn't know that they're all at B.
But at the same time, Rekka's just playing safe because, yeah, that's the reason why they're not going in aggressive and hunting down Dubstep. If they lose a lot of their members, even if they win it, they're still in like dangers. Their economy is still in tatters, so they have to at least have three more people alive for them coming into the next round. So they're going to at least play this as safe as possible, go for the 3v1, make that win percentage chance of the retake higher than, you know, in a 2v1 or a 1v1.
Well, hold that thought. Dubstep actually takes down X-Crit, but it's not going to be enough. Roso takes him down, and it's now a tied score game, 4-4.
All right, I'll believe the guys here saying that it is Rekka's best map, because they're showing a lot of understanding of how actually to time the rotations, even with
the retakes, actually.
Yeah. Rotation retakes.
Especially with that retake. That is a beautiful execution for retake. All of them came in at the same time. Dubstep didn't know where he was supposed to look.
Yeah. Alright, so we'll see here as Mineski will be forced to go into an eco round with just a couple of Deagles, P250s, and a Tech 9. Now we're going to see X-Crit with the AWP go in on to B-Long, but he's not going to find anyone right there. Fish out of water. Not going to happen, buddy. Oh, wait! Adrian spots him out, but... Well, he just peeks it. Just gonna say hi. And Dispenser, are you gonna give your life? Yes, you did. And X-Curate, so on point. Almost catching Adrian. If only he got a little bit closer that, or faster in that peak.
Yeah, and right now Mineski is suffering in the economy standpoint. Only only having Deagles and P250s in the Tech 9.
You have to like how Mineski are playing this. They know that Rekka is going to be playing a little bit laid back, so they're looking for as much good angles as possible. If they're going to go for long range, they have the Deagles to work with, so they have to make this work if they can, but it doesn't look like that's going to be the case. Frost Misty right on top. Dubs have spotted him out, but doesn't want to go for the aerial headshot. He spots out the one, tags him down, goes for the head, but it's not going to happen for him. Gee. With a Deagle, but he's being closed in by four people and he will not survive. Rekka Esports finally getting a round advantage against Mineski.
And yeah, Mineski, they're going to try to see if they can find the answers here. And they gave the AWP to Dubstep. We'll see if Dubstep, if he's not rusty with the AWP.
Yeah, because right now, of course I'm not that knowledgeable with Rekka, so you guys have to help us a little bit. But for Mineski, their main opera is Dubstep, followed by Adrian, who is also a Dubstep, coming in as the new player of Mineski.
Yeah, and Mineski most of the time always goes for the they always go for the double op setup on any map, especially on Cobblestone. But right now, I think they're just trying to play it safe, considering the fact that their economy is not playing with them right now.
Yeah. Look at all of these stalling tactics coming out of Rekka. They just buy Molotovs and nades. Well, of course, it's already a standard, but they utilize it pretty well. Like Mineski actually taking some really good chip damage. And they don't really have to actually put a lot of effort onto that chip damage. Look at that. They just threw a couple of nades, and it works out well for them.
And yeah, proper use of utilities. I'm not going to stress that as much. I can't stress that out as much. I mean, if you have the utilities, might as well use them properly. But yeah, sorry about the misinformation earlier. Once again, this is Shootout Season 3. This is a qualifier for Zen League.
Supersys can actually have a good position right here, and he's gonna go in, flashed up, but Adrian immediately gets the refrag there. GII, look at that, or G rather. Flaring up and gets the kill onto Russo as well. Now X-Crit back onto the site of A yet again. This is a 3v3 situation, but Mineski have control and have actually...
They don't have control anymore. Wow. It's
It looked
it's
like
a Rekka map now.
Yeah, it looked like they could have isolated Excurate there, but there was already the one guy onto the balcony area, and that's not going to spell too good for you. So, there you go, Mineski going to be forced to go for an Eco, or maybe a Force Buy.
I think they are just going to go for Eco Buys here. Just buy up the pistols just enough for the because next round they know that they're going to have money. They're just going to bring give it all. And I think this is going to... I'm hoping this is going to be a full-on B-take because that's going to catch them off guard. Catch Rekka off guard, I mean. And this is going to be a full-on B-take, but the utilities coming in from Rekka, they are being used properly. The retakes are happening. The retakes are real right now. It's now down to a 2v3 situation. Mineski is on the upper hand here. And
Bentek wanted to get the kill onto Retrap there, but he then just got covered, or rather flanked by G.
And yeah, Mineski, I mean, this is looking like a pretty close game for me. 6-5,
skill difference from these two teams.
The words elude me.
Thank you for covering me. But at the same time, like you see little bits of discrepancy from both sides, like inconsistencies from Bentet, who actually was so impactful on the previous rounds that he kind of lost control. Like there was somebody on his left side, but he kind of focused too much on the one man pushing onto the Nectar.
And because of that, it actually catches him off guard and actually bites them in the rear. And yeah, Rekka, they have their ups and downs. That's just what I'm gonna say. And right now, Bentet is he's the thorn on Mineski's side here. And right now, Mineski.
I didn't even see how many kills Bentet has.
Bentet has 10 frags, which is still pretty good considering the fact that he has been fragging every single round.
G is right there on his corner, so he's gonna get flashed. Nice reaction there from Bentet, and he punishes G, thinking that his opponent was actually flashed, and he gets taken down right off the bat. That's gonna be a 4-for-4. And the numbers are stabilized right here. Frost Misty right at the edge of the exit of A long, and Retrack is gonna be the one pushing. Looks like Mineski with 30 seconds left onto the clock. They're pushing actually the slime really, really close to zero, and it's going to be an A take. He spots out the Molotov there, gets a headshot, and he even takes himself an M4A1S for his troubles.
And it's now down to a 4v3 situation. Frost Misty forcing the bomb drop. Mineski needs to play around this. Dispenser able to get a double kill there, and it's now down to a 2v1 situation. Just Supers is on his own. He takes down Adrian. It's now down to a 1v1 situation.
Dispenser has to get the kill here on to Supers or loses the round. He's going to jump up and down. Supers is playing Ring Around the Rosie with him, and he does.
He plays out the round. Very smart play coming in from Supers.
If he kills Dispenser, that is going
Dispenser
to
as well.
Wreck his money.
Wow, that is beautiful. That's smart Counter-Strike there, coming in from Rekka.
Yeah, definitely smart Counter-Strike indeed. But, again, you have to ask, why did they push the time limit too far? 30 seconds left onto the clock, with only 4v4, you know, not having enough setups, kind of made it a bad situation for Mineski.
If they were able to, if they executed a bit earlier, things might have been different.
Exactly.
They might have had time to play with, Rekka there.
But alas, it wasn't for that to happen. So Mineski here has to play a little bit their money in tatters. So not all of them can actually buy nades and such. So there's going to be the trade here with. With Supers is getting the one kill and Excurate as well, and they get the frag or the exchange onto Dubstep and Retrack, and Supers is looking for the double spray down, but he won't connect that, but he's running away and able to actually slip from the hands of Dispenser. He's gonna throw out the flash, but Dispenser is on out of there, but he's the only one remaining for his team. Can he find it in him to actually get the clutch?
Gets one, but he's down to low to 13 HP. He's not gonna be able to do much with that health, and the rest of Rekka know where he is, and Dispenser is just fighting for his life right now.
They're closing in onto him like wolves to the sheep, And from behind, it's going to be Super Sis. He survived all of that damage from the Spencer, and now he's the one who is chasing this lone Mineski Wolf. He's going to be coming out from the corner. They spot where he is. He's making too much noise, and there you go. 8-5, Rekka are starting to pull away with the lead.
Yeah, 8-5, 3-point advantage here for Rekka. We are almost approaching the first half, the end of the first half. And we are just going to wait and see if Mineski can find the answer. I mean, if Rekka closes this out in a 10-5 scoreboard, they have a pretty good mindset for the second half. They'll be able to, you know, they'll be able to close it out. But yeah. If Mineski closes this round and the next round, it's going to be a close fight. And that is where Mineski would shine because, hold that thought, Frostmiski. Actually, Roseau and Frostmiski getting into the action. Retrack going to try to see if he can get another kill for Mineski, but it's not going to happen. 9-5, now in favor of Rekka. And yeah. Wow.
And that's just going to be wood to fire. That is giving so much momentum right now for Rekka, and look at that, they're already rocking an almost 10-5 scoreline. Mineski are in dire straits right now. What can they actually do? How can they come back from this?
I mean, from the way I'm reading it, Rekka is playing very, very basic CS. Mineski is trying to go for the cheesy plays.
But that kind of basic CS is to the point wherein it's so pristine. It's just precise.
It's precise CS. And Rekka spots Frostmiski through the smoke. And wow. It's just a 1v4 situation to end this half. Will Gi be able to clutch this? He's caught in a reload. He's going to go down. Rekka Esports takes the first half 10-5.
And Rekka Esports definitely running away with this game. Now we're going to go into the second half, and it's going to be Mineski now on the CT side. We'll see how Rekka Esports actually approach on their T side. I'm actually curious as how they kind of, you know, become the offensive team, the one who has to get the bomb plant down.
Yeah, because in Counter-Strike, the terrorists always dictate the momentum here. Think of it this way. The CTs will always play passive no matter what happens. The Ts will dictate the tempo of the game. They're the orchestrators here. Yeah. They're the conductors.
Dudes, we already know that he is...
Oh, wow, that was beautiful execution here. They are coming in from all fronts, but Xcurit is the only man alive here. Mineski is able to hold down the side with the bomb drop, and they know where Xcurit is. Xcurit is going to try to see if he can force out a clutch here.
Spots out Adrian there, but he'll be able to win it out. It was a 3v1. Not too much hope for Xcurit there, but Mineski were already waiting for a B rush from Rekka Esports, and yeah, they were able to stop that. So maybe this is the bandage to the bleeding.
Exactly. I mean, this might be the answer. Mineski might perform well this CT side, and I mean, who knows? We might see an overtime.
But of course, Rekka are not going to throw the towel just yet and give Mineski like two or three rounds for eco. They're gonna go and buy up and look for more fights, because that's what Rekka Esports is about. They're looking for these there's close quarter combats, these angles where Mineski are not expecting them to be, and they're there. It's what they do in the first half, and it's actually has given them a lot of wins already, or a lot of rounds already, and that's what they're gonna do again.
And yeah, and here's another rush coming in from Rekka. They're now going to come from Dark, but Retract was able to stop the momentum right there. Gi takes down another kill. It's now down to a 4v3 situation. They still don't know where the bomb is, and they know that somebody is there at Connector. Yeah, everybody's playing a bit passive now, and it is going to be a pull on A side. Dovset, the only guy stopping the long push. Rekka going to try to see if they can get the kill, and Xcurit gets a kill on Gi. Gets another kill on Dovset, and Dispenser stops the bomb from getting planted. Oh, I'm sorry, stops the bomb from getting in. Just BN10 on the side, going to try to see if he can get another one. Adrian takes him down, and Adrian finishes everything up. 10-7. Mineski is catching up right now.
That CZ spray, though, it could have been faster and better, but still, nice try there from Rekka Esports. And let's see a little bit of the scoreboard right here. It's going to be Frostmiski and Bentet leading the frag score for Rekka, 17-16. As for Mineski, it's Adrian, G, and Retrack.
Yeah, all the kills are pretty even at this point. But yeah, Rekka is, you know, they're showing the better skills. But hold that thought. Benthet actually going to try to see if he can get the kill off. Gigi actually takes him down. The push coming in from Rekka onto A-Long now. They are able to force a bomb drop. Dubstep is actually able to force the bomb drop. Now they know that they are going to go for A. But we don't know yet. Mineski is actually hanging a bit back. They don't know where everyone is.
They're going to be pushing a little bit here for the side of Rekka. But Mineski are going to be hunting them a little bit with flashes and smokes just to cut off their exit paths. And Dispenser is going to find the two.
Dispenser with a double kill.
Yeah.
It's just Frost Misty on his own. And that's not going to be enough. Dispenser closes it out with a 3K. And Mineski is now catching up. 10-8 scoreline.
But here we can see that Rekka are going to be able to buy up with AKs all across the board, as well as a few utility to work with. Will Mineski actually buy AWPs? Yes, they're going to be giving it to Adrian actually here. And we'll see if the newcomer for Mineski has an impact. I mean, he has already 12 frags, but we expect more from someone who, you know, is supposed to be a high-intensity AWP player.
Yeah. Adrian with the AWP is very deadly, but we'll find out since this is his first debut on the second debut on the international scene, and this is his first game with Mineski, so we'll find out if he'll be able to make an impact with that AWP. Rekka playing it slow, actually looking like a B take. Nades raining in from Mineski, but yeah, aside from that, I think they're just waiting for the timing here, and Adrian is looking at the angle very closely. Kind of botched that smoke.
He was looking at the angle very closely.
Kind of botched that smoke, yeah. Adrian doesn't know that somebody... Well, it's now down to a 3v2 situation, so nonetheless... Rekka, this is actually still doable for Rekka. I mean, with the high level gameplay that they have, they will be able to... They should be able to do a retake and at least force a plant here.
He's gonna drop down. Adrian misses the flick, but they know now where at least the members of Rekka are. Spots out, gets the kill onto Frost Misty, and Benthet soon to follow. So that was some control for Mineski. One more round, and they'll be able to stabilize or tie up,
yeah,
with Rekka.
And it's now a pretty intense, game. They're able to force out the pistol buys here from Rekka. Need to take care of their economies. Just a smoke and flash from Benthet here, and a fully bought out Mineski. Four kits as well, so there's no excuse to not go for the defuse. But this is going to be a full-on air rush here. That nade's gonna be costing them a lot, but Rousseau takes down Guy. Dubstep gonna try to see if he can guard the bonsite here, and spots out Frosty. Frost Misty, I'm sorry.
Yeah, he gets him through the frost, but there is going to be
surprise,
a
in-your-face
X-Curate.
Surprise, mother.
Getting the kill, and now he's going to be able to get the bomb plant, and this fast take from Rekka. Getting the catch. Catching off guard, Mineski here.
Yeah, and caught them off guard. Initially, Mineski had the upper hand with just being in the site on its own, but... I don't know, Rekka just came in with such a force that, you know, it just caught them all off guard. And they are going to go for saves here.
Yeah, I think what happened there, Rekka's mindset is that they've always been pushing B aggressively or rushing B aggressively. And they always noticed that Mineski has three people on the B side. One drop zone heavily on the side of B and two on the main side itself. So that only leaves one in mid and one in A long. So if you think about it from their perspective, if they actually rush mid and kill G, who is the only one defending there, they kind of isolate, like I said, isolate the one guy onto A long. He gets the one kill on the cross. That was, I believe, Dubstep, right?
Yeah.
Didn't get in the one man kill on the cross. But that was not enough, and his teammates were not able to respond in time. And that just gave Rekka, like, let's say a 5v3 situation. Yes, with fully bought three Mineski people, but the numbers advantage is still in their favor.
Yeah, and if you have just Tech Nines, might as well just go for the train, just rush into the site. And more often than not, it actually wins rounds. Like, if you rush in, just give it all you got, just pray to God that your aim is on point. That's going to be something. But hold that thought. Dubstep and Guy takes down a couple of guys from Rekka. Guy with a double kill onto Super Saiyan Benthet. It's just X-Crit and Frost Misty on their own. It's going to be a full This is going to be a B take. They're going to have to force a plant here. And, Retract takes down X-Grid. It's just Frost Misty on his own. He's not going to be able to do much here. The rest of Mineski, they don't know where the bomb is yet, and Frost Misty still actually has time to rotate. If he rotates to A, the two guys from Mineski is going to catch him off guard.
There's this whole line of defense that he has to go through, so I don't know where he can actually maybe penetrate the defense here of Mineski.
We'll find out. I mean, Frost Misty right now, Dispenser's actually looking at drop. Gonna try to see if he can take the pick, and Frost Misty takes down Dispenser. Now 1v4, and I think this is still doable, but Mineski now knows where Frost Misty is. He's somewhere in the tunnels, and if you're seeing the map, they're all pretty stacked there at B.
Yeah, slick movements there from Frost Misty. Now Retract. It's gonna be at the end of this B long, but this is a 2v1. Frost Misty has to spot him out, and he does.
Yeah. Ooh! Frost Misty takes another kill. Oh, but no, Adrian is there with the AWP. Takes him down. Mineski is now catching up. 11-10. Oh, look at this. The double off setup is now coming for Mineski.
They're gonna fortify themselves even more for long range combat, and we can see that they do don't have a lot of money, so if this actually backfires for them, Mineski will be forced to go for an eco, but at the same time, Rekka Esports are on very, very low economy standpoint. Look at that, Frost Misty forced to actually buy no armor and a deagle in his hands. Granted, his three teammates have AK-47s. This is still an indicator that Frost Misty Rekka Esports need the money.
Yeah, and Dubstep is playing, they're actually rotating their entire team to B. If Rekka reads this properly and rotates to A, it's just Gi on his own. He's gonna be the only guy defending the site. I think what's gonna happen is they're gonna try to force out the rotate, but no, they're actually gonna go in for the full-on take here. No, I'm sorry about that. The bomb is rotating to tunnels. It's now rotating to A. Gi, the only person there. Gonna try to see if he can take down Bentet. He takes down Bentet through the door. He's now down to 5 HP, but will it be enough, though?
Using that door as a shield, it looks like it did. That one single play coming in from Gi, and now Rekka Esports are trying to figure out how to approach a site yet again.
Yeah, Mineski is...
Bomb is actually dropped onto the connector there.
Yeah, still pretty much it's still anybody's game, but Rekka Esports only has 34 seconds to play with here. They need to pick a site. They need to force their way into the site. And Mineski, oh wow, they're actually pretty scattered right now. And Retract takes down Rousseau before getting a refrag, and that Molotov is going to delay the bomb plant. Beautiful picks there, and ooh!
Dubstep a little bit too low on that AWP action, but the bomb has been claimed by Mineski here, and Frost Misty only with a deagle won't be able to get back. There's not enough time, and that's going to be a Mineski win, putting it to 11-11, but they spot out where Frost Misty was, so he loses a lot of money from that one. Look at that, or no money at all, 450.
Just a couple of pistols here going to come in from Rekka. I mean, if they're going to be playing smart, they should at least buy a flashbang.
Yeah.
I mean, as long as you have 1,800 on the bank?
Yeah.
As long as you have 1,800 on the bank, you'll still be able to buy up next round. But hold that thought. It's going to be a full-on rush into A. And Gi trying to go for the spray down. Able
that
to.
That Molotov was perfectly timed, and they at least get the 2-for-2 in terms of the trade. But look
Super
at this.
Sis has the AWP.
Rekka Esports are kind of waiting a little bit for Mineski to actually push out so that they can get the pickoffs.
But there is Retract slowly. Retract is rotating from behind.
But at the same time, Rekka Esports are not going for the cross just yet. They don't have any utility to actually work with, so they're playing this a little bit smart. They're edging Mineski to go in. To go in and risk their lives for Rekka Esports, who have literally possibly nothing except for Bentet and Super Sis with a sniper rifle and an M4A1S.
Yeah, and they're still, this is just a waiting game. They're waiting for the time to dwindle down, but what they don't know, Mineski is waiting for them there. And Adrian gonna initiate the retake here. Dispenser's already inside, gonna see if he can spot out a couple of people there, but it's not He's not seeing, but he knows three guys from... Now Dispenser takes down Super Sissy. He knows people are there. It's just Super Missy on his own. Super Missy sees the headbutt. That Kobe! Oh. That man is not gonna hit! And he's able to take down Dispenser, but he is pretty low. It's a 2v1 situation versus a UMP and an AWP.
He has to get that M4A1S. Get it for himself. Did he pick it up? That's the question right here. If he spots an agent, he's at 100 HP and with armor as well. So, I don't know. I think he should have just took out that M4A1S.
He wasn't able to get it.
I thought he was. Okay. Because it was right in front of him while I was just walking past. Past, his comrade's dead body.
Yeah. I mean, look at this. Pretty scattered buys coming in from Rekka. 3 AKs, UMP, and a Tech 9 versus Mineski's double op setup and 3 M4s.
So looking at Rekka here, Frost Misty with 21 frags, and for Mineski, it's G with 20.
Mineski is...
That's a lot of setup smokes and setup flash as well. They're going to be overwhelming Adrian here, and he is smoked and flashed off. He's going to be charging with the Tech 9, Elahu'ir Hero.
I mean, it's going to be a very different standpoint with just him on his own in the side, and the retake is now coming in from Mineski. They still have the utilities. They can make use of and flush somebody out, and nothing much is happening here. Dubstep taking down Bentet after the kill Bentet made. And, Dispenser, the fastest gun in the West, takes down Excurate. And Mineski will be getting
the East.
East. Oh yeah, Southeast.
Asia.
The fastest gun in the Southeast. There you go.
That's going to be another win for Mineski. Only three more rounds and they get the first map.
Yeah, but let's not count Rekka out here just yet. Anything can still happen here. But yeah, a fully bought AK. Ooh, Rosso not buying... Oh, scratch that. He buys the armor. But nonetheless, a fully bought Rekka versus a fully bought Mineski. What is,
Dubstep gonna go for the peak, but he gets punished. He was looking at three people. Who was he gonna pick in a short span? In like a split second, he has to look for a target, but then not fast enough on the reaction time there. So they're gonna give him an AWP. It's gonna be given to the hands of Bentet. Very deadly with his aim. And only one man on the A side, that's the man himself, G.
And G is going to hold A long here. Two guys from Rekka are gonna slowly push A, but Mineski doesn't know that. And, they're just playing pretty standard CS at this point. Just making sure all angles are secured, and as soon as they see the bomb, as soon as they see something, they're gonna start pushing in.
Rosso was spotted there, I think, by a retract spraying through from the corner of the van.
And Adrian actually takes down Excurate. Bomb. There's still 49 seconds left. They can still go for the rotate, and the rotate is coming now. Oh wow, that was a beautiful shot there from Benta, but Spencer takes him down. So now down to a 3v3 situation. Rosso is pretty low. And they still don't have the bomb just yet. He's sneaky.
He's at the edge of this one, and he's going to go for the cross. Almost does not get the kill there, and even gets the tag himself. But now Rosso in a 1v2. Dispenser is heavily injured here, so one hit actually makes that into a 1v1, but that's going to be a no. And Mineski so close to netting that win.
And a tactical timeout is now coming in from Rekka. Well, what's your take on this? How can Rekka bounce back?
I think they're taking it too slow. Granted that they're kind of getting these picks, or rather safe scans over at these corners, but the problem is when they try to look at an area where Mineski possibly is, they're already waiting and they have the faster aim or the faster trigger. Pulling the trigger, and I think that's kind of like ruining what Rekka wants to do right now. So I think they have to go for their other strat, which is to just force themselves onto Mineski, rush it, and I think that's more effective when they use it once in a while. And this I think is the best opportunity to do that.
And yeah, but Mineski, they need to keep it calm though, because What's going to happen here is if Mineski starts, I mean, if Rekka starts getting on the nerves of Mineski, Mineski might lose their chill. You need to keep it calm. Just keep playing the way they're playing, and they should be able to come out on top.
For you guys who are asking, this is a best of three.
And this is an elimination.
Yeah, we're only on game one. Again, this is Cobblestone. Next will be, I believe, Train. And then after that, Mirage.
And of course, this is Shootout Season 3, presented by Mixbot.
And we are your shoutcasters. I'm Asurai, one hell of a beast, and right here with me is...
Nomad.
Yes.
But yeah, we're just waiting for things to happen. Rekka right now is changing up their strategies here. They want to keep it clean, keep it safe. They're just going to wait for an opening here.
The Spencer getting spot out there a little bit, but he does get some information for his team. And Mineski, very standard defense here. They will see every single entrance that they have whenever the T-side does push in. And now, looks like with 50 seconds left on the clock, they could go for an A push here. Dubstep at the edge of A long, looking for that upshot. Will he actually get it? And right beside him is G, boosted up onto mid here. And he misses the upshot. He's gonna get overwhelmed. Dubstep is taken down. G spotted out as well. And Rekka Esports, easy take on the A site. And even spot retract coming in from balcony, shuts him down. And that's going to force the other remaining members of Mineski here to actually go for the save.
And yeah, it's a 2v4 situation. Mineski, if they wanted to, they can go for the retake, but it's not going to be a smart decision for them. Rekka's going to take this round easy. And considering the fact that, let's take a look at their economy real quick. Considering the fact that Mineski has, as you know, they have as much, they don't have as much money to play with next round, so to speak. So they just need to, you know, save as much guns as they have. Might be good to get a few guns from Rekka, like get the higher caliber AK-47 or the AWP, but you know, that's life.
There's two saved weapons here for Mineski, so they can definitely drop their teammates, so they will buy. Because right now, they don't want any form of momentum for Rekka. Just because if Rekka gets one or two more rounds in their hands with bomb plan as well, their economy is going to skyrocket. And Mineski, yeah, they're 14 rounds, two more to win. But in terms of how this game works in the money system, they are kind of starting to dry up. Yeah. You know what I mean?
I mean, look at Dubstep with the Mag 7. Where is Dubstep? Dubstep is playing pretty aggressive there at middle. And if he actually pushes a bit, he will know that he'll be able to actually get those two if he pushes.
Russo and Super Sis looking at the top of the smoke, playing as safe as possible. I think this kind of works for Rekka in a way, but Mineski kind of thrive in these, you know, yeah, I was going to say that, in these slow peeking situations, because they can see Rekka coming in at the edge of that model character. They immediately shoot and they kind of win the gun battle.
Yeah, and Mineski is playing with their angles right now. Now it's a 4v4 situation, still anybody's game at this point. Rosso gonna try to see if he can actually get a pick there, and he actually takes down Gee. But the bomb is going elsewhere, and hold that thought, Frost Misty actually takes down Dispenser. Adrian goes for the refrag. It's now down to a 3v2 situation. Rekka takes down Adrian. It's now down to just retract, and he's just going to save, and he doesn't know that Rousseau is actually there at A.
Spots out the shadow there and retract. Does he want to go for the clutch? That's the question. That's gonna be a no. He doesn't have a defuse kit, so he's not gonna have much time to work with. So he's just gonna be on out of there.
A shout out to Reese GB as well. Shout outs.
Yeah.
If you want shout outs, we're reading chat, so you can just go and say whatever you want. We'll We'll read the chat.
So for you guys out there who are, of course, from the CSGO Philippines community, shoutouts to you and to everyone else who are watching their teams play. Again, Mineski super close to winning, but Rekka Esports not gonna, allow them to net that easy win. They're gonna be fighting tooth and nail for this one. And now, Mineski forced to actually go for the save, or for the eco, rather.
Yeah, and Mineski's not gonna be able to do much here, to be honest. They have 5-7 P250s and just the USPs. That's not gonna do much against Rekka Esports. The pistols that they have will not be a one-hit headshot, no matter how accurate they are. And they have helmets, so. And it's just a matter of playing it safe right now for Mineski. Try to do as much economical damage to them. And hold that thought, Rozo actually takes down Dispenser. Now quickly down to a 5v1 situation, just Dubstep on his own. He's gonna try to be sneaky here.
He was
here.
Looking right into the face of Excuid. He was looking for the taps as well, and it didn't happen.
It was at this moment that he knew.
He messed up.
Yeah. It's now 14-14. Who is going to match point? Who is going to take the first map?
There's still the point wherein they can go to overtime.
I know. I'm hyping the people for crying out loud. You're breaking the momentum. Oh, man. Oh, You done did it, bro. You done did it.
So now, Mineski have the weapons. They have some utility to work with. And here comes a whole lot of Rekka Esports on to the B site. It's going to be Adrian. The first line of defense gets taken down. He does go for the double spray down. And that's going to be beautiful defense here for Mineski. But at the same time, the backstabbing Frost Misty says no. Gets the one, and only Dubstep remains.
And it's just Dubstep on his own. He's going to try to see if he can go for the retake or for the clutch. The bomb hasn't been planted yet, and it's still pretty much anybody's game. Dubstep can still clutch this, but he is fully blinded, and he gets taken down. Frost Misty brings the team into match point. Will there be an overtime? Will Rekka take the first map?
There's not enough money for Mineski to actually get a good buy here. They're gonna be forcing themselves into FAMAS's as well as UMP's. No defuse kit whatsoever. So mind you, if there is Rekka Esports gonna be able to plant the bomb, Mineski, of course, obviously will be short on time. So we'll just see how they actually, approach this one.
Well, yeah, I mean, if Dubstep was able to clutch that, that's going to be a huge economical damage to Rekka Esports, but
not really. It looks like they have like 10,000
already. I take that back. I'm sorry.
Yeah, this is what I was talking about. Because of how the economical standpoint works here,
Rekka can afford deaths.
Yeah, even
basically.
Yeah, exactly. And Mineski, they should have just won that last game because that was probably the last chance that they had to maybe have good items to work in this round.
Just Adrian on his own, and it's not going to be... What?
Yeah, I think it's part of the...
It's the server, but yeah.
Yeah. So there you go.
Oh, there you go. That's nice.
Yeah. So Rekka Esports has won on Cobblestone, the 14-16 score point. And let's check out the scoreboards right here, guys. So we'll show it to you so you can take a screenshot. And here it is.
This is pretty nice. Yeah. Brought to you by Mixbot.
Yeah, thank you, Mixbot. And Mixbot TV for hosting us.
And yeah, pretty dominant. I mean, it's a back and forth game. Rekka had the upper hand, then Mineski caught up, and it's just a matter of outplaying each other. It was a pretty even match.